somebody has a bad habit of listening to music.
Okay.
My question is, what is the status of
You see, it all depends
music.
On, I mean, this is what you call a bad habit. It all depends on the degree of the habit and the nature of the music. If, you see, the music in itself as a whole cannot be dubbed as bad. Even the wine is not dubbed by the Quran as totally bad. Even juggling and these things are not dubbed as entirely bad. What is described, in the principle described is that a thing which has overwhelmingly or more than 50% bad in it should be abandoned and rejected. A thing which has less than 50% bad things, its better things should be utilized and the bad things should be avoided. This is the principle, okay? Now music falls in the no man's land, in fact. It is neither forbidden entirely nor permitted without any conditions. We know at the time of Hazrat Muhammad Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, when he walked into Medina, the ladies of Medina, welcoming him, sang a song of welcome, plus they beat on the drum. This is called daf. Now, that was a sort of music available to the Arabs. Nobody can say it was not music. But this was not a practice of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam to permit the companions to go on enjoying music, revelries and music, sessions, and to be given up to music. That was not their habit. Instead, they enjoyed recitation of the Quran or listening to the good verses and meaningful verses of great poets. But gradually their taste was developed and they shifted from poetry to the Quran ultimately. So it requires some time of patience to improve the quality of your taste. And without that, to abandon certain things would be rather cruel. In these things, it's a matter of taste. In some other things, the matter of prohibition is fast and hard and you can't change it. You can't say, I have to improve my taste for water before I can stop drinking wine. No, that will not be permissible. Because wine is forbidden. And what is forbidden is forbidden. But music does not fall into that category. For that you can acquire a wise approach of systematic, gradual deliverance from that habit. You understand?
Got it.
And as far as the pop music is concerned, I don't know how people can tolerate that. Just sheer nonsense. No, I don't disrespect music altogether because I know the classical music had some nobility in it. It brought up the best in man in a way that man would not understand. But the music writers were noble-minded. They wanted to bring, even if the theme was miserable, it wanted to bring the question of misery of others to the listener of music, that the others were suffering. They became sad without anybody naming the people, without any tale being told in words. The music delivered all these things. And they became sad and they started crying, not knowing for what, but when they came out of the music halls, they were nobler people than before. So the music served a purpose, and a noble purpose. Here, in the pop music, when the people leave that hall, they leave with some sort of madness and craving for something they cannot have. And for that even, they have to go to kill others or mug others for some drug or something. That elation, artificial elation, requires further help of drugs. So what the taste left behind by this modern so-called music is ugly and evil. And the society under this influence is becoming uglier and more permissive, more careless of the traditional values. So this music is obviously evil and sinful. So I can't treat every music alike. That is why I said you have to be wise and be selective in your choice. Occasional brush with music cannot be considered as a practice whereby you will be sent to hell, I assure you not. But an occasional brush with music which draws you into itself at the cost of higher values, at the cost of memory of Allah, at the cost of prayers, where you are taken over by music and that becomes all your ambition and obsession. If that happens, then you are a loser, obviously. Right?